An interesting point here is we talk about the Obama stimulus plan, but in reality, Obama's stimulus money is going to the states and the local governments and some of the federal agency to administer. It's not like anybody in Washington is really writing any checks.
That's correct. That's correct. I think a big misconception is that the federal government has its money. It's going to roll out and it'll be available. Depending on where you are and what work you do.
Yeah, that I call up my congressman and I say, okay, here, I'm ready to get my Obama money.
Exactly. It's not that simple of a process. Mm-hmm. I think it's convoluted in that respect, is that the states will have control of the money. The federal government will make disbursements to the states. The states will then make disbursements to its various state agencies, and the state agencies will be responsible for making sure that that money trickles down to municipalities, nonprofits in the form of grants or counties or any other, what the legislation calls, subrecipient.
Yeah, I was talking to one of the Congress people's offices, and they were saying to me, you know, people are calling me up asking me for the money, and I have to say to them, you have to follow the process you've always followed before. Now, you had a couple of good tips that you talked about today as far as, you know, getting involved in this, you know, government, state, local process.
Right.
So why don't you repeat a couple of those tips, because I thought they were really good.
I think some of the key things are, number one, figure out what services that you're providing and what agencies at a state level or local level are looking for those services.
So give me an example of a service and an agency.
One of the agencies is the GSA.
Okay.
Is looking for contractors in various parts of the country to do construction work, retrofitting some of their facilities.
Okay.
While they don't have large amounts of money to build new facilities, they do have funds available to do some renovations and upgrades.
Right. Okay.
So in each state that houses a GSA facility, in every city that houses a GSA facility, the likelihood is that there are some monies being spent on renovation and retrofitting for either sustainable energy or green certification, or just for age in general, requiring some update.
Well, I mean, a lot of these federal agencies and federal buildings date back 40, 50, 60 years.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So there are opportunities, I think, that exist there for trade contractors and general contractors as well to get involved with some GSA work and get some history there. Another one of the things that I think is advantageous and helps to take advantage of the stimulus is networking with these agencies, making sure that you're aware of the people who are heading up the programs that are stimulus related, making sure that you establish relationships with the people in those agencies. Establish relationships with the local legislators, council people, all of the elected officials in your area, in the areas that you do work, if it's outside of your home office area. But also consider partnering with firms who have done government work in the past. I think that is an avenue that will give great benefits to companies who haven't had experience, small companies who are looking to take advantage of the stimulus program.